not all that is true, but obviously we're allowing the truth to be stretched a bit a little bit.
Disclaimer.
Thank you, Cam. It wasn't too bizarre.
Fifty years.
Now, really think about that. That's a long time. It's two of Chelsea's lifetimes. It's two and a half Haleys. It's 25 Maddies. It's 0.8 Steve Roberts. Tonight's about stories, and obviously there's going to be stories, and I couldn't get my family to tell them all, and I don't want to tell them all, and you know, there's stories from my 20s that I don't remember, there's stories from my 30s that were extremely embarrassing, thank you, stories from my 40s that frankly are just kind of boring, but you know, the 40s were okay, 40s were good, looking back. Some of you knew me, I had a midlife crisis when I turned 40, I did the Body for Life thing, I lost 26 pounds. Bought Harley Davidson, got a leather jacket, got a tattoo, you know, cool man stuff, you know. Not yet, so, you know, testosterone. And it was all good. It was good. You, as a guy, you do those things kind of for like a struggle with identity. You know, it is testosterone based, and it serves a purpose. Of course, that season of my life, all it really did was help me tackle boyfriends in the front yard, be a badass. That kind of thing. So that was good. And then you move on to the next thing, you know? And for me at that point, I sold the Harley, and I bought some bitching windows. I put a pillow on the back of my jacket. Go ahead and gain the weight back, because you can't be too sexy now. Okay, no. I kept the tattoo. If you haven't seen it, you saw some of the pictures. It's a crown of thorns that go around my bulging bicep. It's kind of looking like a hair scrunchie right now, but it's all right. You know, it's all good. That's why I brought her, thank you. But you know, turning 50, it's a big thing. Yeah. I totally forgot what I was going to say next, so I got to clean her for a little bit. Okay. It is about identity, you know, it really is. There's a lot of places we find identity. Now my new identity is just, I'm a grandfather. And that's really cool. I like being, I'm silly papa. and that's all right. I can be the cool, silly papa. I'm okay with that season of my life. Where I get upset is, you watch TV and you see how grandpas are on TV. You see that? I was watching TV the other night, and this toddler's like, "Grandpa, Grandpa," and I'm like, "Hey, Grandpa." This guy's like Wilford Brimley, like really heavy, comes limping over, like bends over to kick the kid up, and his knee major's bionic Keurig starts interfering with his lifeline necklace. And like goes up, and it just pissed me off. I was pissed. I pissed my depends. Thank you. It was embarrassing. They shut the TV off at the MCL and went home.
I get it, Vince. I get it.
Where's the snare, man? We got a snare. I got a snare. No, but, you know, we look for identity in a lot of different things. You saw all these pictures. They were me looking for me, okay? And you know, ground control, Major Tom, you know, performance art, whatever it took, I'm okay. I understand that. But as you get older, you start letting those things go. You know, you recognize them for the fake things that they are. And we only have problems if we don't let go of them soon enough, and accept the new role we're in. And I think, at least for guys, the hardest thing to let go is our sexuality. You know, I got it, you know? For example, Carmen and I took Carmen out to dinner or to lunch on a Saturday a while back this summer. And it was a nice day, we're out, and I was rocking it that day. I was rocking the jeans. I mean, you know, I accidentally saw myself in a few windows as we went by, you know, to see what the store was about. And so we go, and we eat at this place, and it's one of those places where you get your food, you go up to the grill, and you know, and they cook it for you. and so we're sitting down at this table, and in front of me is the windows, and there's booths there, and there's this young couple sitting at the booth. Now, I like to do the detective thing, you know, where you look over and you're like, trying to figure out, are they married, how long have they been together, are they happy, what do they do? You know, so I'm checking them out, and yeah, late 20s, early 30s, and she's obviously unhappy, he thinks he hit the lottery, you know, and he's getting his food, and so he gets up a little later, and he goes over to get his grill on, he leaves, and Carmen goes, and she orders the same thing, so she leaves. So I'm sitting there drinking my tea, and I glance up, and she looks up, and she goes this way. I'm like, huh? I go over and look back down. A little awkward, you know, drink my tea. Look back over there. She says, hit me. I'm like, damn, dude. This chick's flirting with me. I still got it. Didn't she see the ring? Oh, the ring, this, you know, that's
come on. This.
So anyway, sitting there, just thinking about it. And my wife comes back and she says, isn't that cute? I said, what? She goes, that couple over there, he reminds me of you. He was up at the booth at the grill, and he was looking at her, and he was flirting, and he was waving, and she's looking at him giggling. So anyway, you know, it's false identities we do, and they lie to us. We lie to ourselves. But at least we got the internet now, right? We can pretend we have relationships. I can peer into your lives, and I can put the pictures I want you to see about me. And I can, if I want to be witty one day, I'll put some on there. If I want to be philosophical, I can put something deep. And, you know, I can cut lyrics out of songs and act like they're in the back of my head. And, you know. But you know, trying to figure out what the internet says about you, that's a little tough. The best I can figure about myself is that I'm paying too much for my mortgage. But it's okay, I had some relatives that died in South Africa, and I just got to send my ID stuff, and I'm like, my manhood is too small, but there's a pill for it, so that's all right. I don't know who Ashley is, but she wants me to have her pics real bad. So, you know, that's not really real. Speaking of technology, I don't know if you've heard our Lily, local Lily company, and Apple are actually teaming up on our product. It's called... Yeah. Called ICLS. It makes you ready to text anytime you want to. The bad news is you each have to be in separate bathtubs. Honestly, what's with that? Seriously, it's crazy. If you've seen the Cialis commercial, which I've seen them, if you turn the sound down, you swear it's an LSD commercial. So it's like, ready whenever the moment is right. And they're like, okay, the moment's right, but holy shit, the ground is moving.
Walls are moving, plates are turning into tents, turning into beds, tripping around, and then they both chill out in the bathtub side by side, staring at the sun until they come down.
I think these EDM products, it's the same kind of thing. We're a consumers-based society. We want things now. We don't really do the work for them. We want them right away. We want them approved. Okay. I tried it once, I tried it once. For her. So my wife and I, every year, we go off to the Belterra for a couple of days to celebrate our anniversary at the spa, little gambling, little slot machine, slot machine. And so a friend of mine gave me a couple. I thought, yeah, this, what the heck, I'll try it. So I took one the first day, it was good. Let's just say it made things easier. Right. So it's in fact, it was so good. The next day, I thought, what the heck? I'm going to take the other one. Now, for those of you that are up on your ED products, CMOS lasts 36 hours. So effectively, I double dose. Now, I'm not a doctor, and I didn't sleep in the Holiday Inn last night. But
perfect time.
I don't pretend to know how these things work, but they impact your erogenous zones, okay? And mine's probably like most people, a little here, here, there's a spot here that I'm kind of fond of. Double dose from Cialis, it went from there to... it's like around here. You know, we all kind of have that one spot, you know, and so for me it was my skin. which it's a little awkward when you're in a casino full of blue-haired ladies smoking cigarettes and playing slot machines. So it's like a jackpot, you know. Really, if we're talking about getting older and stuff, then honestly, the whole, you know, keeping it interesting after 25 years of medicine, it takes work. It really does. I don't think a pill's the answer. I think you just have to work on it. I mean, I was thinking back, you know, in your 20s, it was a lot easier. I mean, 20s, you go upstairs, you go to bed, and you don't carry that medicine. It's the middle of the night or whatever, you go up, and you're just like, rip your clothes off, you jump in under the seat sheets, and you like cuddle, or you spoon for the night, and it's just like, you know, it makes it easy. Now you go up to bed, you know, get into the bed, you peel your clothes off, and you know, you brush your teeth, and you take the rest of your clothes off, and you help each other take your socks off, and your back's hurting, and you're moaning, you're passing gas, I put my rash cream on, little scrub, so she puts on her fleece warm-up that I think she got from a Joan Rivers garage sale. You know, we jump in the bed, and then we start packing the pillows. You know, it's like we're packing sandbags. The weird thing is that still fits. It's just, I'm just fine standing first, you know. Certainly I'm going to beat it out for a double. And, you know, most of the nights I'm just happy to lay down the bunk. Anyway, that's enough of that. Thank you. I'm going to go into some stories now. And I just want to say one thing. You know, I've got a lot of friends that, people I know that believe that the threads of our lives are accidentally tangled. And I just hope you guys know me well enough, the friends I know now, that I believe they're intentionally weaved together. And I just want to take this moment before we get carried away, and I'm still not pissed off, that I'm thankful that each one of you represent a colorful thread that makes up the tapestry.